Hello everyone, I'm your educator Anjali. I hope all of you are doing good. The topic for today is mountain passes in India, important part of our Indian geography. But before I start, I have another very important announcement to make. This is a very important announcement according to me personally, because whenever a person is preparing for prelims, I think all of us want a personal coach. People who can tell us where we are going wrong, what to do every day, what to study and everything. So a personal coach is required for everybody, and I'm so glad that an academy has come up with this now. Now you can get a personal coach and you can enhance your UPSC preparation, and you are unique. So your learning is also unique. So your needs are unique. Wouldn't it be great if you have a personal coach who can help you at every step of your journey towards cracking UPSC? It sounds so good to me, but it's possible now with an Academy Iconic subscription. If you haven't yet upgraded to the Iconic subscription, please upgrade it and enjoy benefits like personalized study planner, study booster sessions, high intensity workshops, and a lot more. The link of the same I have provided in the description box below. Subscribe using the code SHARMA20 to avail 10% discount. Please make the full use of this. This is like one opportunity that every aspirant might be dreaming of. Let's start with today's classes about the passes, the major passes that are in India. The passes in the Western Himalayas first. Okay, first in Jammu and Kashmir, there is Mintaka Pass, Parpik Pass, Kunjareb Pass, Aghil Pass, Banihal Pass. Why these passes become important? Because they are given in the match the type of questions, and also in news, if it is appearing, you will be asked about the other passes that are present in that region as well. So when you are studying about the passes, it's better you make a map and just mark them. Okay. I have told you how to make a simple map, 3 threes and a V. Okay, 3 threes and a V is very easy. Jammu and Kashmir, just mark Minitaka, Parpik, Kunjareb, Aghil, Banihal. Okay, then there is Changla, Kardungla, Lanakla, Pirpanjal Pass, Zaratagla, Imisla, Pensila and Zojila. Zojila is usually confused where it is present, whether it is in Sikkim or whether it is in Uttarakhand or it is in Jammu and Kashmir. Please remember, it is in Jammu and Kashmir only. And here you can see I have mentioned the passes. Usually these passes are asked for you to arrange them from north to west, or north to south, or east to west. So I think this will be helpful. I have taken it from an authenticated source. So this is a very good information, and it is a correct information that it is provided here. Okay, I told you what are the passes that are present here. See, you can see Zojila, Aghilla, Karakoram Pass is present here. There you have Zartagla, and there is Changla, Lanakla, Kepsangla, Jarala, Imisla, Shipkila, Barlachala, Pensila, Rotang, Banihal Pass, Pirpanjal, Parpik Pass, Kunjareb Pass. And here you have other passes towards the Pakistan side. Here you can see Komal Pass, Bolan Pass. Don't get confused, they are not present in Jammu and Kashmir. And please remember this diagram, or make a note of this diagram, or take a empty map and map these, okay, by yourself. You can see I'll just tell you where the India map is. Here it is. Okay, it is like this. I think this should be helpful, because I found it very helpful here. Okay, just make a note of this. Just mark them when you are making the map. Just mark this. Just make a map only this much and mark them. So you will know when you have seen it visually, you will know from east to west and north to south. Here if they have given you, see, Changla, Lanakla, Kepsangla, Jarala. You know from north to south, you can arrange them easily. Usually these passes are asked, that is Zaratagla, Aghil Pass, Zojila, Kardungla, Okay, then is this Banhilal and Rohtang pass. These are usually asked for you to arrange them, but all the passes are equally important. North to south, they can give you any passes. So I have covered the important ones here. So just go through this. Please mark them on the map by yourself. Then only it will be helpful. Then in Himachal Pradesh, there is Barlachala, Debsala, Rohtang and Shipkila. Barlachala, you can see here. Barlachala, Rohtang, Shipkila and Manapas. Not Manapas, Debsa Pass. Okay, where is Debsa Pass here? Okay, it should be somewhere here, okay? If it is not here, just mark it. It should be somewhere here. Then Uttarakhand, Lipu Lake, Mana Pass, Mansadura, Niti Pass, Mulingla. And whenever you are marking, please mark if here you can usually cover three states, okay? When you are marking, three states can be covered here. Mark them with different colored pens. That is Jammu and Kashmir, mark them with one pen. Then Uttarakhand, mark them with another pen. And then other state, Himachal Pradesh, mark them with another color pen. Then you will know the different passes if you mark them with different colors. Then Minnetaka Pass, Kashmir, China. These are important because they are present where the usually the conflict or something takes place. So their location becomes important. And it is at the tri-junction of India, China and Afghanistan. So where is Minnetaka Pass? It's here. Okay, it is at the tri-junction of the three. So that is important again. It is between Kashmir and China. Parpik Pass is between Kashmir and China. It is east of Minnetaka Pass on the Indo-China border. Where is Parpik Pass? It is here. Okay, Kunjare Pass is also present there only. These are bordering with China. Please remember them. Another pass is also there with China. That is Kunjare Pass. It is in the Indo-China border. Here, the same pass. Minnetaka Pass, Parpik Pass and the Kunjare Pass are sharing border with China. Minnetaka also shares border with Afghanistan. And then is Agil Pass. Agil Pass in the Ladakh region of India with Xinjiang, Xi'an province of China, 5000 meters above the sea level. North of K2 peak, the highest peak in India and the second highest peak in the world. Mount Everest is not in India. Okay, please remember that. K2 is there in India. Then Banhilal Pass, it is in Jammu and Srinagar, it is present. 2832 meters and it is across the Pirpanjal range. This also you should remember in which range it is present. It remains snow covered during the winter season. There is Jawahar Tunnel that is built. So Banhilal Pass is also important. Then is Changla. It is Ladakh with Tibet. Altitude is 5300 meters. This meters is not usually important. Just remember which country it is sharing border with. Okay, Changla is between India with the Tibet. It has a temple dedicated to Changla Baba, after whom the temple has been renamed. Then there is Kardungla. It is in the Ladakh range. Here you saw someone in the Pirpanjal range. Here another person is in the Ladakh range. It is 5600 meters. World's highest motorable road passes through this pass. Here when you are going for a road trip to Ladakh, you go through this pass usually, the Kardungla. It will remain closed in winter due to heavy snowfall. Then there is Lanakla. It is between India and China again. Aksai Chin, like I told you, when you are marking the places which are sharing border with the countries also, mark them with different colored pens. Mark the passes that are sharing border with China with other color pen, Tibet with other color pen, and China and Afghanistan together with India with other color pen. So you will remember them very easily. Make maps in a bigger size, okay? Don't make it very small. In one A4 sheet, make this map, okay? Paper will never go waste, but that information is very valuable, I tell you, okay? You will remember it very well, north to east, north to south or east to west, arrangement of these passes, you will remember it like anything. This pass provides passage between Ladakh and Lhasa, a road that connects to Xinjiang province with the Tibet, has been constructed by the Chinese people. Here then there is Pirpanjal range. Okay, Pirpanjal Pass is there. It is in the Pirpanjal range. Provides the shortest and the easiest metal road between Jammu and Kashmir Valley. But this route had to be closed down as a result of partition of the subcontinent? This also can be asked. Which was the pass that was closed down during the partition? That was the Pir Panjal Pass. Then is the Zaratagla Pass, Indochina border. Please correct this. It is border across the Karakoram range. See, ranges are important, so I have mentioned them. Ranges located at an elevation of over 6000 meters, not very important that meters and everything. Imisla is in the Ladakh region of India, Tibet in China. Pensila, it is a vital link between Kashmir Valley and Kargil. It will remain closed to traffic from November to mid-May due to heavy snowfall. Zojila Pass is an important link road between Srinagar on one side and Kargil and Leh on the other side. So there is a pass that is present here, that is the Zojila. Here there is Srinagar and there is Kargil and Leh on the other side. The road passing through this way has been designated as National Highway NH1D. Again important, Border Roads Organization is responsible for maintaining the road and cleaning it off the snow during winter. In spite of all these efforts, the road passes through this will remain closed from December to mid-May. Usually the roads that are there or the passes that are there in Jammu and Kashmir, usually they are closed during the snowfall season. Then there is Baralachala Pass. Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir at an elevation of 4800 meters. There is national highway that is connecting Mandi in Himachal Pradesh with Leh in Jammu and Kashmir. It will pass through this pass. Being situated at a high altitude, it is snow covered in winter and it is not used for the transport route. Depsa Pass is between Kullu and Spiti districts. It is at an elevation of 5270. There is nothing that I can teach in this subject. I can just tell you where that pass is present and what is that location important for. Okay. All you have to do for this is mark them on the map. After you mark them at the back of that page itself, just make one line. Okay. Just make one line notes of all these passes from these slides itself. Other than this, there is nothing more that is required for these passes. Only if they come in news, just keep adding to those points. That's it. Okay. It offers a much easier and shorter alternative route. Traditional Parbati Pass route between the Kullu and the Spiti Valley. Then is the Rohtang Pass. Rohtang Pass is between Kullu, Lahul and Spiti Valleys at a height of 3900 meters. Border Roads Organization. I like to tell you one more thing that was asked about Border Roads Organization. What all do they do? Okay, they do the security work also, but they also clean up these roads when it is snow covered. Remember this. Who does the work? It is BRO. It is responsible for constructing and maintaining the roads in this area. Rohtang Pass is a great tourist attraction and traffic jams are very common because this route is widely used by the military, public and the private vehicles. Usually when you go to the Jammu and Kashmir region, many people will use this road only. Okay, even as a tourist you will be using this road. So that road is usually a busy road. Then is Shipkila. It is Himachal Pradesh and Tibet, 6000 meters. See, just compare which meters is the highest. Okay, just make 1, 2, 3. Okay, highest one, second highest, third highest elevation. Just make these things, it's done. All this about the passes is done, okay. And then this elevation is 6000 meters. It will remain closed in winter, November to April. Lipu Lake Pass, it is a tri-junction of Uttarakhand, India, Tibet, China and Nepal borders. This pass is used by the pilgrims to Kailash Mansarovar. It is used to Kailash Mansarovar. Then there is Mana Pass, Uttarakhand with Tibet. Elevation 5610 meters, situated a little north of the holy place of Badrinath. Something that is near to Badrinath is the Mana Pass. Remains closed in winter. It is understood. It will remain. It will be closed. Okay. Then this is the Mangshadura Pass. It is in Uttarakhand with Tibet. It is used by pilgrims going to Kailash Mansarovar again. Niti Pass, Uttarakhand with Tibet, remains closed in winter season again. Mulingla Pass, Uttarakhand with Tibet again, situated in the north of Gangotri Glacier. It is an elevation of 5600 meters in the greater Himalayas. Then the passes that are there in the eastern Himalayas, very very important. Sikkim, there is Nathula, Jileplla. Nathula is in news, so Jileplla is becoming important like that. Okay, Arunachal Pradesh, Bomdila, Dihang Pass, Yongap Pass, Difer Pass, Kumyang Pass, Pungan Pass, Chankan Pass. Okay, I have this will be usually asked from east to west arrangement or west to east arrangement or north to south and south to north. South to north will not be asked, north to south arrangement will be asked. Okay, just remember them and mark them when you are marking. See, you can see the Indian map over here. Okay, it is like this. Okay, just take a map, make only this much map, mark the same places, write about these in one line. Okay, I'll tell you what should be written in the next slides. Just write one line about them and keep the notes. Just keep the notes with you. Okay, very helpful for your revision. Sikkim, Nathula, Sikkim with Tibet. It is an altitude of 4300 meters. It forms a part of an offshoot of the ancient Silk Route. It is a part of ancient Silk Route. It is an important trade route between India and China. It is closed after the Chinese aggression on India in 1962, but was reopened in 2006 as the governments of the two countries decided to enhance their route through land routes. Then is Jileplla again. It is in the Sikkim-Bhutan border. This is in the Sikkim-Tibet border. This is in Sikkim-Bhutan border. Altitude is 4300. Chumbi Valley, important link between Sikkim and Lhasa. Important link between Sikkim and Lhasa. Arunachal Pradesh, Bomdila, 4300 meters with Bhutan, situated at an altitude of 4331 meters in the boundary of Arunachal Pradesh in the greater Himalayas, connects Arunachal Pradesh with Lhasa. Dihang Pass, Arunachal Pradesh with Myanmar. Arunachal Pradesh will become important because it is having borders with Bhutan and Myanmar also. So it becomes important where which pass is connecting to which country. Elevation of more than 4000 meters, it provides a passage. It is providing passage. Yongyap Pass with Tibet, okay, other in Tibet. This Decipher Pass, it is very important. Trijunction of India, China and Myanmar. Easy access between Arunachal Pradesh and Mandalay in Myanmar. It is an important land trade route between India and Myanmar. It will remain open throughout the year. Kumjiang Pass, Arunachal Pradesh with Myanmar. There are three passes. Kumjiang, Pungan, Chankan. Now please rotate your phone because I couldn't fit the image like vertically. So I have made it horizontal. These are the passes that are present in the western coast. Okay, so here you can see the Goram Ghat, Haldi Ghati Pass, Asir Gha, Khasra Ghat Pass, also known as Thal Ghat or Thur Ghat. I think you understood where is this. Okay, this is Gujarat. Okay, and here is Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala. Okay, it is this western coast that is all these are present. And then there is Malshej Ghat or Nane Ghat Pass, Bhor Ghat, Kumbharti Ghat, Chorla Pass Ghat, Pal Ghat or Palakkad Ghat. These are present on the western coast of India. Okay, please mark them. Take a map again, mark them. These are not very important, but these will be asked, might be asked from north to south, or east to west will not be asked, but north to south arrangement will be asked. So please do this map marking. Don't lose marks in questions like these. I hope this lecture was helpful. To find the PDF of the same lecture, find it on our Telegram channel, Simplifying UPSC with Ease. If you haven't subscribed to Arpita Sharma Classes, please do subscribe and press the bell icon so you don't miss an update from us. Thank you.